It's Marissa, and today I have a really exciting video for you guys. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to color your hair at home like a professional would in the salon. I asked you guys on my Instagram, which is always linked down below, so go follow me, if you guys would be interested in seeing this, because I've been coloring my hair at home for quite some time now. It's dark, so it's pretty basic. If you're doing like a one color, like all the same color type of hair, it's super basic. Yeah, I've been doing it for a long time now, so I figured why not show you guys. First, if you guys are new here, hi, my name is Marissa. I do videos on makeup, hair, fashion, music, everything. Please hit the subscribe button down below. I make 2 videos a week, so go subscribe. Thank you. All my social media links are down below as well. Follow your girl, okay? So before I get started, I just wanna like ask you guys what you think of having like a plain background like this. If you guys like that, or if you don't, I'm going to be switching up my filming area for the next 2 months. It's gonna kind of get, I'm gonna figure out what I like. So yeah, let me know if you like more of like a plain background like this, or if you would like more of like a something of like my bed and like vanity or something like that. Normally in like videos like this, I like to give a disclaimer and be like, oh, and I'm not a professional, but I'm actually a licensed cosmetologist, so I kind of know what I'm talking about a little bit. Granted, I don't know everything, so if you guys have any tips or if I do something wrong, let a girl know, okay? Let me know. I didn't want to put that disclaimer out there that I am kind of knowledgeable about the subject. I did go to school for this. But yeah, so that's why I color my hair at home, and I was like, honestly, unless you're getting like highlights and a balayage and stuff like that, you can definitely do your hair at home. So yeah, this is gonna be for anybody that just wants to color their hair at home. Number one, don't use box color. I'm gonna show you how to not use box color, okay? Please don't use box color. Don't do it. How to color it like a professional, I swear to you guys, it's like $7 more, if that, to not use box color and do it yourself at home. It's not more, like, that much more expensive if you're doing it yourself, so. Don't use the box color. Please, please, I'm begging, okay? Your hairdressers are begging you. But yeah, so let's just get on with the video. I'm just kinda gonna show you, but this is what the final result is. I mean, it's not done right now. It's, like, in a ponytail, but you could see. If I had regrowth and roots coming in, you would see it because it's, like, slicked back. So that's it. I'm gonna shut up now and let's get into the video, and I hope you guys enjoy. Let's go. Okay, so I'm starting out by taking my professional color. I like to use the Paul Mitchell, but chances are if you are not a professional, you can't get this color. So I would go for the Ion brand at Sally's. But I take a 1AA, and then this is going to be a 3A. So basically, the lower the number, the darker the color, and then A most of the time means like a blue, like ash color. So I like to do this so my hair is super dark. And then I take a Tupperware bowl, some gloves, a brush, and then I take this 10 volume developer. As long as you're going the same color that you've always had or darker, you can use a 10. If you're trying to go a little lighter, use a 20. And then I like to put about half of the tube in there. This one was an old one, so I used like the bottom half. This one is a new one, so I'm gonna use, you know, the top half. And normally I don't recommend mixing, like these are 2 different lines by Paul Mitchell, but they didn't have the colors that I wanted, so that's what I do. And then I just kind of eyeball how much developer to put in, and you want to make it like even. So if you did 1 ounce of color, you want to do 1 ounce of developer. You can measure it out, but I like to eyeball it until it looks like a cream, kind of like frosting, and then I look super ratchet, but it's fine. You can see all the roots that I need to cover. And so then I section my hair off. I like to do a lower and a top half, and then I put a towel on just to protect my shirt and stuff. And then I'm putting on my gloves, and I know the lighting in these clips are so funky. And then I like to very carefully go around my hairline first, just so I can really focus on not making that look crazy. And then I like to go in all of the sections that I separated first, just kind of outline them. This way I know exactly what I'm working on. And then I take horizontal sections. No, these are vertical, I'm sorry. Vertical sections. When I do it on somebody else, I go horizontal. That's probably what they do at the salon. But when I do it on myself, I find it so much easier. I'm losing my voice. I find it so much easier to go vertical. So then I did both sides, and now we're going to do the top. So I take down the top, and it's literally the same thing. And if you were painting your whole head, you're just gonna color the whole piece of hair, obviously. But since I was just doing my roots, I only do like an inch.
So yeah, so then I separate what I did from what I haven't done yet. And yeah, I literally am gonna do the same thing. I just outline the whole section just to make sure, because those are the places that are probably gonna show the most, like, you know, where you part your hair and stuff. But yeah, it just makes it a lot cleaner too. And then yeah, it's super simple. I just paint it back, and it's just more time consuming than anything, and your arms are gonna start to hurt. But besides that, it's seriously so simple. Throughout when I'm painting my hair as well. So then I did both sides, and I only do this when I do it on myself just because I can't actually see, but I like to run my fingers through it and just kind of massage the color into my scalp. It's kind of weird, but just in case I missed any place, that way I make sure I get it all. And that's literally it. For this color, I like to leave it on about 30 to 45 minutes, and then I just wash it out in the shower.
Okay guys, so that was the entire video. I hope you guys really enjoyed. I hope you know, it was knowledgeable and you like learned something maybe, but, or entertaining. I don't know. I hope it was something. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys aren't subscribed yet, please hit the subscribe button down below. It's literally free, okay? Not many things in this world are free, but subscribing to me is, so just do it. Also, my Snapchat, my Instagram, my Twitter, they're all linked down below, so follow me as well. Give this video a big thumbs up and leave a comment, and I will see you guys in my next video next Monday or Thursday. Peace out.